Hi everybody. This is a tutorial video to get an understanding of what is TDD and to get a quick start with that. TDD is a test-based methodology, but at the very first step, why I should write a test. If you're not familiar with tests, typically unit testing case, it's a software testing method to ensure any small pieces of the code works just as expected. By writing tests, you will not be afraid of refactoring the code and making changes because you will notice if there be any failure in code just before your changes end up in production and messed up the functionality, especially in a team when the code base is shared to get modified. When you write tests, you will learn to not trust your own code. You realize how it's difficult to get the code from the first shot, and practicing on that makes you a better developer with more confidence. Okay, let's go ahead to understanding test-driven development. TDD method is test, then code. It means you need to write a test first, then get a fail, because obviously there is no code to test at the first step. After that, you write the code to make the test pass, and you can refactor your code while you repeat these steps. The idea behind TDD is if developers write a test before writing functionality, this will encourage them to consider how the code will be used just before writing the code, and it helps them to create a better code and project progress faster. Once a test fails, the developer understands what needs to be changed and how to refactor and improve the code without altering its function. Eradicating fear of change is the first benefit of TDD, developing high quality and extensible code with less bugs, being easy to spot functionality issues, and avoiding code duplication all are the benefits of TDD. There are many testing frameworks and tools for PHP, such as Codeception, SimpleTest, PHP Unit. I'm going to cover PHP Unit as the best known testing framework for PHP. So, first let's prepare our environment. If you use Composer, it's easy to install the PHP Unit. Just follow the order by copying and pasting the command. I'm going to use the latest version, so this command is enough. To make sure if PHP Unit installed or not. Yeah, PHP Unit is here. I'm going to create two folders, one to put our class inside, SRC, and one to put our test class, test. Let's say we are going to have a product model. For our product, we need to have a class named to product test. So let's create files too. Also, we need to update our composer.json by putting our SRC into autoload. Now our simple environment is ready and we are good to go. For product test class, PHP Unit Framework Test Case. This is it. What we need to test in this test class? It's very easy to predict. The product class needs a name property with a getter and a setter, and we need to test these methods. Before of that, let's declare stick types. Two stick types, PHP will throw type errors, which is very helpful in writing tests. I'm going to write my first test, public function test name void. This method is going to test both of the getter and setter. The test method starts with this word as a prefix, so PHP unit can detect it as a test. Inside of this block, first I need to initiate my product. Then I can set the name. For example, product 1. And finally, I can expect to get the same string with assert equals. Now let's execute the test. To do that, we just need to call PHP unit with our test pass. I'm going to make the colors enable. It's ready. You can make a configuration file for PHP unit to define your options or your config. I personally prefer to just use composer.json. It's your choice. I'm just good to go with manually adding this option to the command. Okay, we got our first fail because the product class was not found. We have done the first step. Then for the second step of the TDD circle, we need to write a code and try to make the test pass. I'm going to code the product class, included these two methods. Nesting in here, string types. Put your namespace. SRC in case. Class. Product. So to make our methods, I need to add the name property. For getter, and for setter, now run the test again. Failed again, caused the same error. Sign we're using Composer, it's necessary to call Composer dump autoload to generate autoload files. It's done and passed. Okay, I guess my product needs some tags too. Then let's make a test for that. Initiate the product. Set some tags. Assert equals product. Get tags. It's better to convert it to a variable. Honestly, I need to add that tags too. Now I can expect it here. Also, I should to be comfortable with these things. Just a duplication. check it again. Of course it fails. Let's do some coding and make all of this stuff. For add tags, it should to add the tags or tag at the end of array. Let's fix it. Okay. What about hashtags? Okay. And clear tags. This is it. Test it again. It fails again. Going to make it pass. One more test. It's good enough. I'm just repeating myself with this initiation every time. So what about refactoring the test class? The parent class contains a method called setup. It calls just beforeish test. It's simple to initiate it right here instead of initiating each time. Okay, in another hand, we have teardown, which calls right after each test. Now it's easy just to replace this product instead of product. Quantity, for example, 12. We need to get a fail first. It's done. Let's code it. For getter. Integer. And for setup, bool. If it's be greater than 0 or some more conditions. One more check, it's done. As refactoring the product class, we have three properties, and it's better to initiate these properties in construct. Just as a final check, it works just fine. Okay, we can predict much more things for product class in product test, but this is enough, I think. So this is just the basic of how TDD works. It wasn't a hard example, not a real world one. For each test, I wrote a test first, then I made the code for that and tried to refactor the code. TDD sometimes is fun when you code alone, and sometimes it might be boring. It depends on you. I tried to keep this video short. It's usual for me to use some plugins to speeding up the coding. Maybe I make a video for that later. But in case, I failed to keep the video simple. Finally, thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, please give it a like. And if you would like to get my next video, please press the subscribe. Bye.